Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Roshni and this is Betu Grew Up, a channel where we talk about mental health and self-worth. In today's video, I wanted to talk a lot about just the feeling of being totally overwhelmed, not really knowing how you feel, not really trusting yourself. And so obviously if you've ever experienced this or if you've ever been through depression, you know how debilitating it can be and how horrible it can feel a lot of the time. So my heart goes out to you if you've ever felt that way. You know, if you can relate, just know that you're totally not alone. A lot of people with depression, you know, have to deal with these really scary thoughts and like these imposter syndrome kind of thoughts. And when that's mixed with anxiety too, you know, just constantly have like this mix of feeling guilty and feeling like you have energy to do things, but that energy ends up being fear-based and just kind of pushed from like this fear of failure aspect, and that's not always the most fun or the healthiest way to be looking at things. If you have been dealing with, you know, not knowing how you feel, with changing perspectives, with feeling just overwhelmed with emotions, with just feeling really anxious and you can't pinpoint exactly what it is, stay tuned because I'm going to give you a really useful tip to help you kind of start to figure out how you're feeling again. The first thing that kind of goes down the drain when we're starting to experience overwhelm or when we're getting really disconnected from ourselves is we kind of lose that mind-body connection. I used to do yoga on pretty much a daily basis, and I notice that, you know, when I genuinely have that like true mind-body connection, I feel so much more centered, I feel more aligned with myself, I feel more honest, I feel more transparent, not even with other people, but just with myself. I feel like I'm a little bit more in control. It just fosters something really deep within me and makes me feel really aligned. And for a lot of people, you know, maybe it's not yoga, but maybe it's martial arts or you know, just going to the gym and like your workout ritual that you have. Anything that really helps you feel connected and grounded is something that I notice is one of the first things to go away when you start feeling overwhelmed. So even if you haven't been, you know, doing a daily workout practice, if chances are, if you're feeling really depressed and really anxious, if you're just feeling like completely overwhelmed by life, your odds are feeling that connected to your body. You're not wanting to go out and go on a run. You know, you might be eating junk to feel a little bit better. You might be drinking a little bit more. You might be smoking more. When you don't know how you feel, one of the first things that you can do is start to reintegrate that mind-body connection. And that doesn't mean that you have to start working out right away or start a yoga practice. Just start noticing where in your body you start feeling certain emotions. And our choice is, you know, either to let things build and build and build and then explode the first time something happens, or our choice is to check in and to do something and to figure out what's the underlying cause of getting us frustrated or angry or pissed off, and then, you know, treat that, do something about it, address the problem, or just take a little more care of ourselves or give ourselves a little more time off and a little more time to check in so that we don't feel so lost and so at whim, you know, because when we feel like every single thing is the straw that's going to break the camel's back, and when we don't even know when we're going to explode on someone or yell at a receptionist or yell at a cashier, like, that's not a good way to live life, and you feel so out of control if that ends up being you. You know, you're constantly flustered, you feel like you're always late, you feel like you're always missing something, you feel like you're always spilling things, like, you're just in that, like, flustered mindset where you can't, like, see clearly. And in order to start seeing clearly again, notice where in your body you feel certain emotions. So when you find yourself being completely angry, or, you know, if you can just take a few minutes and think about something that would make you angry, or, you know, watch a scene of a show that is something that, you know, always pisses you off, take that moment and do a little doodle, do like a little stick figure sketch of a body, and, you know, color in red where you feel anger when you think about anger manifesting in your body. Do you feel it in the pit of your stomach? Do you feel like your entire face just gets red? Do you feel like your blood is boiling, like, in your chest? Like, where do you feel that anger? You know, do a little doodle and just write anger at the top and color in where makes you feel angry, and that's all you have to do. Or just circle the area. It doesn't have to be that deep. It doesn't have to take that long. But start keeping track of you know, where in your body you start feeling emotions. On the next page, think about when you feel really anxious. Is your stomach in knots? Do you start sweating? Do you, like, you know, start stuttering on your words? Do you gesticulate a lot? Do you play with your hair? Do you have a certain nervous tic or a habit? I tend to, like, pick at my cuticles. Some people will bite their nails. Whatever those little things are, just write a quick bullet note or, like, a quick one-word description of what you tend to do, and then circle again, like those parts in your body where you start to feel really, really anxious. When you are super happy and you're super lit up, you're obviously probably smiling. Maybe you're laughing. Maybe your body feels light and free. Again, you don't have to, like, wait around and have a journal ready for the next time that you're happy to, like, do a quick doodle. Like, it doesn't have to be that, like, invasive on your everyday life. All you have to do is give yourself, like, maybe 20 or 30 minutes, and like I was saying, just start thinking about, you know, a really happy memory, or start thinking about maybe something that makes you angry, even stories from friends or articles, anything like that, that would make you feel either angry or anxious. You know, you can do one emotion a day. You can sit there and you can, you know, spend 30 minutes to an hour going through a lot of the major emotions and just kind of notate where you feel it in your body, how you feel it manifesting, what physical symptoms does it give you. And all of these things are really important to note, because the next time you start to feel overwhelmed, say, okay, my stomach is in absolute knots, I'm sweating, I, you know, just can't stop biting my nails, I'm probably really anxious about something. Okay, let me think about, like, what I'm freaking out about, or what am I scared about? What do I have coming up in the next couple of weeks? Or maybe what did I dream about last night? Like, it at least gives you some sort of basis to work off of to help you figure out how you feel. And I know that to some people, like, maybe some of you just know how you feel all the time. Maybe you're never confused. Maybe you're never overwhelmed and you just don't understand what that could feel like. But for someone, you know, who has a depression and anxiety, and I myself, I have panic disorder. So when I get a lot of panic attacks, I tend to depersonalize. I tend to dissociate. I tend to just completely cut myself off from my surroundings. And when you're having identity crises and you're having panic attacks and you're depersonalizing and dissociating from your day-to-day life, it starts to be really easy to question everything around you and to feel like a total alien in your own environment and in your own home. So it might be really strange for some of you to even consider or to think about, but if this applies to you in any way, shape, or form, definitely take it into consideration and think about, you know, doing this little simple exercise. And the reason I say to doodle it or to write it down is it's almost like a food diary. You know, you're not going to remember what you ate on a Tuesday 3 weeks later, so you might as well write it down and refer back to it. And it's not something that you need to obsess over. It's not something you need to check in with every single day, but it's just a tool to help you feel like you have some control and, like, you understand yourself and, like, you understand your body a little bit more, because our bodies genuinely hold more emotion than we really think. That's why things like emotional freedom technique and neuro-linguistic programming work, because we hold so many emotions in our body. That's why a lot of us get sick. That's why, you know, a lot of us do have physical symptoms with any single emotion that we feel or face, because our bodies and our minds are connected, and we need to keep that connection and that conversation between our mind and our bodies going, because our bodies really can tell us so much more about what we need intuitively, and we just need to listen to what it's saying and start paying attention, because that could be, you know, the biggest teacher of all. Is not, you know, some coach or some videos or some inspirational content, but what your own body is already telling you. So I really hope that this video inspires you to check in with yourself and take your body a little bit more seriously, especially when it comes to managing emotions and figuring out how you feel. If you have any questions or if you try this, definitely let me know in the comments below. If you want more content like this, subscribe and hit the thumbs up button. Happy healing.